So we're going to take a look at Google Calendar's new focus time insights and a little bit more about working hours. Now this is a feature that is actually locked inside of Google Suite and more recently added in the start of November 2021. I actually didn't know this feature existed and sort of got a nudge from a friend that it actually existed. So huge shout out to Steve Rowley for bringing it to my attention. Before we begin, if you're new here, hit subscribe, and if you enjoyed this video, hit like. It'd be great to have you here in the Keep Productive community. So let's start with working hours. Now, working hours has been a fundamental part of Google Calendar for some time now, and it's a little bit more flexible than it was, which is a great addition. You can get Google working hours through going Settings, General, then Working Hours and Location. Now you can actually enable working hours through G Suite accounts, and from here you can set what days and what times you can work. But more recently they've made the ability to change and add new hours. So for example, let's say you work between 10 a.m. and 4 p.m, but then you do an hour in the evening, you can add that hour on a specific day, which is really helpful, or even use it across the week. You can also enable working location as well. Now, once you've got all that set up, you can create something called focus time. And this is actually available when you go ahead and create a new event. Now, when you create a new event, there are a few options. You've got event, focus time, out of office, task, and appointment slots. So you can actually add more depth to whatever you're adding to your Google Calendar. But let's hone in on focus time. So once you hit focus time, you can do a few things. During that period of time, you can automatically decline meetings. So for example, if you wanted to automatically decline new meeting invitations, that helps to block any time. For example, if you're working on a project or you're in that meeting focusing on something and you don't want additional meetings to appear. You can also automatically decline new and existing meetings, which is something you can either choose and select. Now, obviously, when you automatically decline meetings, maybe some of your team or other people who are external might need to know why, and you can actually leave a little message. And the one that Google auto create is actually decline because I'm in focus time, but you could change that to I'm working on a project. Hopefully we can organize something soon. Now you can naturally add a bit more detail like you would with any other Google Calendar event. For example, location, you can add a description and attachments, and even what at the bottom comes up, you know, all the regular settings with default visibility or notify them 10 minutes before, and you can adapt that in your own settings. So the third element to this is actually quite interesting because Google have, well, I felt like they should have been in this market a very much a long time ago with Google Calendar, but there's something called Time Insights, and that can be accessed on the left-hand sidebar. This gives you a bit more analytics and insight into how you're spending your time, specifically with, for example, meetings and focus time. Now, if you click Time Insights, you'll get a right-hand sidebar, and this gives you a bit of insight into the month that you are working in. And it starts with the ability to select your calendar, so you can change what calendar you actually want to find information on. You can see how much focus time has been added, how many one-to-ones you've been having, and maybe even guests that are above 3 in a meeting, and also things like how much time you need to respond to things, and also the remaining time in the week, and that's based on your working hours, in which you can actually adjust there. So that's really helpful to see a bit of insight into how much extra time you actually have in your working hours. Now below you can actually see the time in meetings, and it actually breaks it down into recurring or one-time meetings and how much time per month you spend on meetings. Now you can also see when you have the most meetings. For example, you could have the most of them on Thursdays, and how your daily average ranks up. So for example, if you have, you know, 2 hours of meetings on average, then that will show that there and update in real time. So this information is really interesting when it comes to being able to pull it together, find out a bit more about how you're working, specifically when you're managing, you know, your team and things like that. It actually encroaches on a space that Clockwise has been doing really well in innovating. And Clockwise has actually been working as, I believe, like a Google Workspace partner in creating this more advanced AI system to analyze how you spend your meetings and really give you insights, but also help you to channel focus time. So if I compare them directly, obviously, obviously, initially, they're not directly similar. I think Clockwise has definitely got much more insight and depth in terms of being able to schedule that. But it's a nice step forward from Google, and hopefully we'll see more updates like this in the future. Anyway, folks, hopefully that gave a little bit of detail into how Google Focus Time works. Let me know in the comments below whether you've been able to play around with it. Remember, this is currently only available through Google Suite accounts, so you'd have to be working in a workspace to be able to get access to this. Sadly, you won't be able to get access to this on your personal Google Calendar. Anyway, folks, a big thank you. Please do make sure to like and subscribe this video, and I'll talk to you very soon. Cheerio.